When a person simply engages all the time in a shahwat, in his empty desires, then he becomes what the ulama call a nafs al-bahima, an animal-like self, right? Pursuing your desires without any form of, you know, without any restriction, just like the animals, right? The animals, if you can summarize the life of an animal, the animal is territorial. Why is he territorial? Because of his ego. An ego is the mother of all evils for human beings, right? His ego. An animal will eat, drink, sleep, and mate. And you'll find human beings that do nothing more than that. The reason why they earn money is to occupy more territory, to feed their ego, so that they can buy nicer food, so that they can mate, and that they can sleep. That's the reason why we make, that's the purpose, the limited scope and purpose of some human beings that have neglected the ultimate purpose, which is to worship and please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and serve Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-A'raf, وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا. If we willed, we would have exalted all of them with that. Just like the angels, we would have forced them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not given them a choice. And we would have exalted their status with the Qur'an, with the message that was given to them, with that purpose was given to them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. But that person chose to cling to the earth, meaning he clings to the worldly desires, وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَى, and he just follows his empty desires. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكُهُ يَلْهَثْ. And so the example of that person is like a dog. If you chase the dog, then he will be panting, and if you don't chase it, he will be panting. Meaning what? No matter what, the dog's tongue is always out. And as Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, that this is something that the dog has that no other animal has, that the tongue is always extended outwards. The dog's tongue is always out. And in essence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that a nafs al-bahima, a human being becomes like that. Not only does he sin because he's under pressure, because, you know, he fell into a hard situation, and, you know, he buckled to the pressure, or whatever it is, or he found himself in unfavorable circumstances to strong iman, or whatever it is, right? It's not that, but you get to a point where your heart becomes so hardened that you're planning your sins in advance, that you're pursuing sins that you don't even need, you just feel like it, right? And you don't need any sin, but you're not even pressured, you just feel like it, you just pursue your desires so emptily that you become like a dog in that way. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. May Allah protect us. But in essence, the lisan, the tongue always being out of that dog, in essence, these human beings will have the limited purpose of just trying to get as much as they can, right? Get as much as they can of these desires. And that's not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us for. Wal-iyadu billah, may Allah protect us.